I wore a continuous glucose monitor for a month, and after the end of my experiment, I stopped eating mangoes and I started eating bread for the first time in many, many years. This is the strange story about how all of us have very, very different and unique digestive systems, and how all of us have very different metabolic health, and why it's so important that you learn about your unique body. Hey, my name is Lucas. I'm a yoga teacher. I'm a nutritional coach. I am not type 2 diabetic. I do not have insulin resistance. Just for your reference, my recent A1C test was at 5%, and my fasting morning blood glucose average is in the mid-90s. While I would love for those numbers to be a little bit lower, for all intents and purposes, it would be impossible for me to get a diagnosis of prediabetes or diabetes. No one would diagnose me with any kind of metabolic disorder. Anyone you talk to would tell you that it's a total waste of time and money for me to use a device like this, and they would be wrong. In this video, we'll talk about why everyone should use a CGM, a continuous glucose monitor, for at least 2 weeks to understand how your body works. Number two, we'll talk about how to get one of these devices. And number three, I'll give you some tips for best practices so you can make the most from your two-week stint with one of these stuck into your arm. As a disclaimer, I am not a doctor. Please work with your doctor. I have put a PDF down below with some instructions on how to use these things, some language, how to communicate with your doctor. I think you'll find it helpful. You can grab that down below. Here's my story with blood glucose. My very first nutritional coach was a medical doctor who was obsessed with blood glucose. Almost all of his work was with type 2 diabetes patients, and he was using lifestyle interventions to get them off insulin. He was really successful in the short term, not so much in the long term. That's another video for another day. But what he taught me was to go down to the pharmacy and buy a finger prick glucose monitor. It cost about 20 bucks. I got one, and he had me checking my blood glucose in the morning and after meals. It's called postprandial blood glucose. Here's what I learned. Zero. Nothing. I learned nothing. My morning glucose was low. My postprandial glucose was low. I threw the device away, and that was it. End of story. I put my focus on other things in health and wellness. I figured this blood sugar thing, not for me. Fast forward about 15 years later, I started having really bad sleep problems. By sleep problems, I mean I'd wake up at 3 or 4 in the morning, covered in sweat, drenched in sweat, and delirious, really, really disoriented and confused. I assumed I had some kind of massive hormonal problem, so I got a bunch of blood work done, and the blood work showed nothing. No one really knew what was going on. Quite coincidentally, at that same time, one of my podcast listeners sent me one of these things in the mail and said, Lucas, you've got to stick this on your arm. It's been life-changing for me. So I did. Here's what I found out. In the evening, I was eating mangoes. I love tropical fruit, and those mangoes, as you would guess, sent my blood sugar a little bit high. They'd give me a spike. Nothing crazy, definitely not what I'd like, maybe 140, sometimes even 145 milligrams per deciliter. Not good, but not terrible. What happened next is where the terrible thing happened. I suffer from something called reactive hypoglycemia, not hyper, not going up, but reactive, meaning when I go up, I come way down. 3, 4 in the morning, I was having 70, 60, sometimes as low as 50 milligrams per deciliter. That's a full-blown hypoglycemic event, confused, delirious, sweating, all of the above. When you don't sleep well, you have a bad day. When you have a bad day, it screws up your focus and your mood and so many different things. And it all came down to mangoes. I could not believe it. Got rid of the mangoes, started sleeping much, much better almost immediately. I had gotten blood work. I had gone to see doctors. There's nothing, no one could have ever helped me with that except for this silly little thing stuck in the back of my arm. As you can imagine, that led me down a whole rabbit hole of experiments to understand how my body, how my digestive system works. Why is it different? Well, in our gut, all of us have about 3 pounds of bacteria. Like soil, the soil in Barcelona is different than the soil in Boston, is different than the soil in Tokyo. Our microbiome, our microbiota, those little bugs in there, are very different. And it seems like it has a very big effect on how we digest and metabolize foods. There are other things going on as well, like the health of your liver and your hormones and genetic factors and a whole bunch of other things we don't understand. Here's what I learned. Fruit for me is kryptonite, especially sweet fruit. What that means is mangoes, apples, oranges, especially things like grapes, they will spike me up, but even worse, I will have this reactive event that will drop me down so low, I have to sit down and sometimes lie down in the middle of the day. Now, this is heartbreaking for me. I love fruit. I love tropical fruit. I just eat less, or I eat it rarely, or I eat a little bit, and I try to put my focus on lower glycemic fruits. Please know that this is probably not how you will react. In fact, all of the best information will tell you this is not how anyone reacts. That information, for me, is wrong. This is how my body reacts. I have tested this dozens and dozens of times. Second thing I learned, completely blew my mind, is that bread, especially when it's with oil and vinegar, has very little impact on my blood glucose at all. What that means is for someone like me, bread with oil and vinegar is a healthier food than a mango. Even saying that out loud now, I find that very, very hard to accept and believe, but the numbers don't lie. That's how my body reacts. Other things that I learned from my experiments. All of the usual tricks that people suggest, they worked for me. I don't know if they'll work for you, but it's worth testing. What kind of tricks? A salad, front-loading a salad in your meals because of the fiber, that really helps to slow down the hit of blood sugar. Number two is vinegar. Adding vinegar to your salad or to your food, that really, again, slows down the blood glucose response for meals for me. Avoiding all carb-only snacks is really, really crucial. I can eat carbohydrates very well, but I need to pair them with fat or with protein to slow down the absorption. But the number one thing I learned from all of my experiments, aside from the mango thing, was that movement after a meal is absolutely amazing for my blood glucose. What that means is if I have a big dinner and I stay seated in my chair at the table, or if I go sit on the couch, my blood glucose will have a pretty predictable spike. Maybe it'll go to 125, maybe even 130 milligrams per deciliter. However, if I stand up, if I walk around, if I play with my kids, do some chores around the house, it's very common that my blood glucose won't even cross 100 milligrams per deciliter postprandial. That's about 1 to 2 hours after a meal. This change is so dramatic and so simple to do, and it can have such a long-lasting impact on my health. What does all of this data that I've learned have to do with you? Maybe something, maybe nothing. What it means is you need to experiment. Your body's different. There are things you don't know. Maybe it's the mangoes. Maybe it's the movement. Maybe it's the vinegar. You really need to understand your body. And you can do that now with one of these devices. If you go online, you'll see all kinds of different companies like Levels and Vary and NutriSense. They're all using this device. It is made by a company called Abbott Labs. It's a medical device, so there aren't a lot of competitors. In fact, right now there's really only two devices. One is called Dexcom. That's very expensive, mostly for type 2 diabetics. And then there's this Abbott Labs Freestyle 2 or 3 device. This is what everybody's using. It doesn't matter who's selling it. Everybody's using this device. Hopefully there will be some other manufacturers in the future. The medical industry is really tightly regulated. This is safe. It's simple to use. It doesn't hurt. They call it a needle, but it's really just a filament. You can install it at home. It's very, very simple to use. So how do you get one? The least expensive option is if you can get your doctor to prescribe one and if your insurance covers it. Now, for a lot of people like me, I can't get insurance to cover it. I don't have a metabolic problem. I don't have any signs of metabolic disease or blood glucose management problems, no signs of insulin resistance. So I pay for this out of pocket. Depends on where you buy it. If you're able to get a prescription and get it from the pharmacy, your out of pocket might be $75 for 2 weeks. It can be as high as $150. For 2 weeks. Now, that's a lot of money, and that's a big, big expense. However, I would argue that it's worth it. What you'll learn from this in those 2 weeks is enough to really impact the next few years of your life. A lot of people get obsessed with these, and they wear them every day, all day, forever and ever. I don't think that's necessary. Most of you will find everything you need to know in just a couple of weeks, and so while it is a significant investment, oftentimes you can get enough data in that short period of time. If you're talking to your doctor, the best thing to say is, there is type 2 diabetes in my family. I promise that's true for you. And I would like to do everything I can to avoid metabolic disease, specifically type 2 diabetes. I would love to wear an Abbott Labs Freestyle device for a couple of weeks to learn, see what they say. Some doctors are very supportive, some are not. If they're not supportive, go online. You can order one. Again, check the PDF down below. I'll show you how you can find one online with or without a prescription. Okay, you get a device. You install it, you stick it in your arm, you put a little bandage over it like this so you can swim and shower and you don't have to worry about it. What do you do now? Well, the app that comes with your device is free. There's no need for a second app, and it comes with your Freestyle Libre device, and you simply hit scan, and then like an Android, you scan the back of your arm, and then your device will tell you your current blood glucose. So my current blood glucose is 103 milligrams per deciliter. I'm about an hour and a half since I had some food. And so I had a protein shake and I had some nuts this morning. And so my blood glucose is relatively low for postprandial level. This is something I'd be happy with. What I'm most happy about is that relatively flat line here on this graph. What I mean by that is my blood glucose is mostly stable from when I wake up all the way throughout the day. We often say that we want to have high energy, but that's not really what we mean. We'd like to have stable energy because for most of us, the highs come with lows, and that roller coaster is not what we're looking for. You've got the device installed. You've got the app on your phone. What do you do now? You've got 2 weeks. How do you make the most of it? Pay specific attention to what happens with sleep, with stress, with food. Those are your big things. Many people find that when they're stressed out, their blood glucose rockets. This has to do with your cortisol levels and your body dumping glucose into your system so you can go fight tigers. Many people find that when they sleep poorly, like less than 6 hours per night, sometimes they even have pre-diabetic fasting blood glucose levels. Because again, their body thinks, Lucas is only sleeping 4 hours tonight. There must be a war going on. Let me dump a bunch of glucose into his system so he can go fight. And then I go sit behind the computer and I'm stressed out. The third thing to pay attention to, which is the most obvious, is how foods affect you. Look at fruit, look at starch, look at carbohydrates specifically. You might find that rice is kryptonite for you, but potatoes are not, or vice versa. And it can be really helpful for you to understand how you can pair foods, how you can time your meals in a way that can have an advantageous effect on your blood glucose. And again, what we're looking for is a relatively flat line of blood glucose management. My challenge to you would be to give this 2 weeks and see if you don't find something as big as what I found. Removing mangoes and moving around after meals quite literally is changing my metabolic profile in a way that's setting me up for a much, much healthier future. It's very, very simple for me to do. Hope you found this video helpful. Again, grab that PDF down below with some reference and ideas for speaking to your doctor and ordering a device. If you'd like more science-based yoga videos, hit subscribe down below. If you have experience using a CGM, good, bad, indifferent, I'd love to hear from you in the comments down below. You can find my teaching calendar at yogabody.com, and I'll see you in the next video.